What's up, SaaS Masters? My name is George, and today I want to show you a system that's gonna let you translate your websites super fast and, best of all, super easy. It's called Linguise, and it's really easy to use. Now, in this video, I will be showing you how it actually works and how easy it actually is to install. I will be doing a test on WordPress so you can actually see that you can do this for yourself without complicating things. You don't have to manually translate things. It does it automatically. But if you want to fine tune it and tweak the translations, you're also going to be able to do it in live mode. So let me show you what I'm talking about right now. All right, this is the Linguist site, and you can translate to over 80 languages with this system. It's super easy to use and implement. Now, it's really important that you have several languages available, especially when you have users coming in from all over the world, because you might find people that don't speak the language, the native language that you're using on your website, and you need to translate it. They would have to do it manually or use something like Google to translate it, but this does it automatically inside of the site. Let me give you a quick example in their site. There's this little flags that we can view right here, and if I click on it, we can view a pop-up of the languages that this site has available. There's several ways that we can display this, but this is just a really easy view of what's capable of Linguise. So let's just say we want to translate this to French. We'll just click on it, and boom, it opens up the French section right here. And if we want another language, let's just say something more complex like Japanese. Well, complex for me, but obviously not for them. And now the site is in Japanese. It's that easy. Let me show you another site that we have here for demo. This is an ordinary site, a WordPress site that we have. Again, the site is native English. And if we click on the flags, well, we can translate, for example, to Hindi. Okay. All right, there we go. Now it's translated to Hindi, just like that. Super easy and super fast. Now, let me show you what's going on behind the scenes now in the display, for example, the analytics and all of that, because this is really important. Plus, at the end, I will be showing you how to install it for yourself on WordPress. So let me jump into my Linguise dashboard, and we're going to use this site as test, log that video, and we're going to view, whoops, let me log in. Okay, again, let me go into test, log. Okay, here's the analytics for this site that we're specifically looking at. We can see, for example, the translated characters for this specific site is 9,000. The translated words is 1,000. The input bandwidth that's been used, the request, and page views per language. Okay, this is really interesting because you're going to know where or what languages your users are actually speaking, okay, or understand. In this case, for example, we're viewing Spanish, which is 50%, German, then we have Japanese, Hindi. This is just a test site, but you're going to be able to view what percentage of your users are, what language they're using or they understand. Multilingual page views. So for example, are they using it or not, or are they just using the English language? We have the most visited view pages information. Okay. We also have, for example, the rules available if we want to add a new rule for it. For example, we can give it a title, the type of rule. Do we want to ignore specific words? For example, ignore text, replace, context exclusion, or exclusion by URL. These could be due for several reasons, and it's good that we have the option. We can also text to ignore. For example, if we are talking about a brand, we don't want to translate it because, let me give you a quick example. A brand that's a word, I don't know, Nosso, which is a deal that's going on. You don't want to translate it because that's an actual word. Or for example, radar, which is a word, but there's also a SaaS. Well, we can ask it to ignore it and, well, don't translate it because it's a brand name. It's not a word. We can apply to URLs or selected URLs, apply to languages, apply to HTML content, and exclude in URLs. We have those options available. We have the translations that this specific site has, okay? And we have the live editor. This one is really interesting because if we want to fine tune the language, for example, I'll select Spanish for this one, which is my primary language. If I want to translate it, I can go, it jumps me to the actual live site and I'm able to translate it. Why? Because there might be a little mistake in the translation, or maybe I want to give it that extra personal touch in that translation. Well, I'm able to do it on live. Right now, I'm in the viewing mode. You can see navigation. But if I click on Linguist Editor, now I'm able to actually edit the text right here. So for example, this is the translation and I can actually type something here and translate it myself, just in case they made a mistake, just in case you want to give it a personal touch, or if you want to change the words to it, you can actually do it right there in live mode. So that's pretty cool, right? Next thing we have is obviously the settings. So in this case, we have the installation code, the domain, the native language that this site is on, and the translation languages. I can add more languages right here if I like. Like they mentioned, there's over 80 languages that we can give them access to translate, and the translation URL. So that is the power of Linguise. Like, it's super easy to do. Now, like I mentioned before, I will be showing you how to install it. Why? Because you might be saying, hey, you know what? That might be super complex. I've tried other plugins, I've tried other things, and it's just super complicated. I need to create pages, I need to create the translations, and it's just too complex. Not with Linguise, let me show you. Okay, so here I have one of my test site, and this is just a site I created for this purpose, okay? So it's a WordPress site, clean site. All I did is install a theme to it. So let me go into my back dashboard. Let's go to add new plugin. And I am going to search for Linguise. All right, I'm going to install it. Okay, let's activate it. Okay, we have it installed. Let's go into the Linguise menu right here. And we're going to need our Linguise API key, all right? This is where we're gonna get it from, the Linguise dashboard. Now, I've created a test account right here. You don't need a credit card to test it out. I'm gonna add my domain right here. Everything is from scratch, okay? There's a site, the account, it's this one. The native language of this site is English for this case, and it's gonna translate it to these languages. I'm good with it, translates the URL, I'm good. Let's go next step. All right, here's my API key. Let's go ahead and copy it. Go into our installation here. Let's go ahead and apply it. Okay, it's applied. And what we're gonna do is we can fine tune the settings right here. For example, I can insert alternate link tags if I like to. We keep it on for SEO purposes. The language list display, is it gonna be side by side, a drop down or a pop up? See how it updates on the right? So for example, I select the drop down. Side by side or a pop-up, okay? If I click on it, it's gonna be pop-up like the examples you saw in the beginning. So we have those three options. Do we want to display the flag? No, just the language name, or the other way around, just the flag. I think the flag looks really nice because basically someone who's looking for a translation will automatically view flags and you can select it. So either keep flag or language name, both, however you like. The language name display, are they gonna be English from the native speaking site or native language? So for example, well, in this case, I'm not displaying. Oh yes, it is, okay. Franchise, and obviously that's in Chinese. This is in Spanish, Espanol. And that's the way we can display it on native language or English. Okay, flag style, round, rectangle, flag border, radius, flag size. We can change all of that, make it smaller, bigger. Language name, color, language hover color. The flag shadow, we can change that, flag shadow on hover, and all that good stuff. Okay, so let's just say we're good to go with that. Remember, we added the API key, we set that. It's already added our translated languages right there. And there's one more thing that we have to do. We have to add the flags to the menu. So if you're on WordPress, this is what you would do. Go into menu and select the primary menu. In this case, I'm already on it. And I'm gonna add the Linguise switcher. So let's add that right here. And it added the flags to it. So let's go ahead and save menu. Let's go preview our site. And there we go. We have the flag in the menu. So if I click on it, it opens up the pop-up because that's how I selected. And that's how easy it is to translate your WordPress site with Linguise. Like you saw, I mean, just install the plugin, added the API key, few settings, and we're good to go. Just to finish off, I want to show you the other platforms that it's available. So these are the integrated integration platforms. They're WordPress, Joomla, WooCommerce is also available, JavaScript and PHP. So if you are, your site is not one of these platforms, well, it's probably one of these other ones. So JavaScript and PHP, OpenCart, PrestaShop, Magento, and Drupal. Well, guys, that is Linguise. If you want something super easy to implement on your site, to translate, well, this is the way to go. Like I mentioned before, there's a discount coupon code in the description in case you guys want to use it. I thank you all for watching, and I'll see you on my next videos.